Hello, welcome to Cloud Technologies. So in this video series, we are going to see how we can integrate Salesforce with MuleSoft. So this is our first video of this Salesforce integration series. I hope you will subscribe and follow our next videos as well. If you are visiting our channel for the first time, please subscribe our channel, watch our videos and share it with your contacts so that and press the bell icon as well so that you will get notified whenever we uploaded a new video. Okay, so let's get started. So here, to integrate with any Salesforce platform, the first thing you need to do is you need to create one developer account in Salesforce. So once you have created the developer account in the Salesforce account, it will send you one password link and a token link for you. So I will explain the setup process in this first part of the video, and I will explain how you can configure the Salesforce connector in our Anypoint Studio. Okay, so let's see these two stuffs in this video, and let's continue in our upcoming videos, like how we can query an object, query an account or contact object from Salesforce. And in next video, we will see how we can create a new object in Salesforce by using Mule 4 version and latest connectors. Okay, so let's get started. So to create an account in Salesforce, you need to log into this developer.salesforce.com. I will provide this URL in description box. Here you should create one account with your Gmail ID. So you need to click on the sign up. And you can fill this form. So I'm providing basic details. You need to select your role, and whatever the role you can select, that is fine. And in your company name also, you can give any name, even your name also you can give. You need to select the country, and you can give any valid postal code, and you need to select the username here. This one you need to remember while logging into your Salesforce. Okay, so the form of email address, right? So you need to give any username at the rate of some domain.com, just the example which is hovering here. So we can say clarity demo@clarity.com. this should not be a valid email address. You can give any other address, but the format should be in the email address form. But to be frank, this clarkdemo@clark.com is not an email address and it's not available. But we need to provide this in this form. So that's why I have given it. Okay. So you need to just click on sign me up. Now you will get one mail to your Gmail account, which you have filled at the first box. So please check your email to confirm your account. Now I'll log in my Gmail account, and I'll see if I get the email from the Salesforce developer account or not. So once we receive the mail, we need to set up our password. Yeah, so I have received a developer@salesforce.com email here. So you need to click. So once you open it up, it will show you the login letter URL and your username which you have given. Okay, and you need to click on this verify account. Here it will ask for you some security question and to set up the password. See, you need to change your password. And this is the first time you need to set up your password. You need to follow these three rules. Password should be 8 characters, and one letter, one number should be there. So you need to remember the username and password. Okay. And you should fill any security question just for your remembrance. In case if you forgot the password, it will help you to remember that one. It will act as a hint for you. Okay, so I'm just select CLAT here. Next, you need to click on change password. And in case if you forgot the username, you can find username here, but you need to remember that password which you have just set it up. And this is how your Salesforce developer account looks like. In general, in your real-time projects, they will give you, I mean, your project manager and your team will give you the access for this developer account. You don't need to create that. So if they have any organization, they will provide that access for you, so that you need to set up this password and you can use this. Okay. So this is how you need to create a Salesforce account. And you need to do one more thing here. You need to set up a token, reset token here. And once you receive that token, then while configuring that Salesforce connector in your Endpoint Studio, in our MuleSoft environment, we need to have these three details. Okay. Let's see how we can set up that token. So to do that, you need to click on your profile picture here, and you need to go to settings. And you can search it here like reset my security token, or else the direct option is available for you, reset my security token. Okay, you need to click here and see for the first time it will show you this button. If you are already having the Salesforce account, then it won't show you. Okay, this is the first time I have created, so it will ask me for reset security token. And one more thing, this Salesforce developer account is valid for 30 days. So I'm just clicking on reset security token. Once I clicked on it, the token will be sent to my email again. You need to copy paste that email, I mean the security token as well. Okay, so I just clicked on it. Now I'm navigating to my Gmail account again. See here, from support.salesforce.com, you will get this security token, and this is the secret one. You should not share with anyone. And your username security token, it will show it for you. Okay. So this is how you need to create a developer account. Now let's see how we can configure this Salesforce connector in our MuleSoft. So to demonstrate this Salesforce connector configuration, I have created one demo project, Salesforce demo. Okay. So you can create any project in your workspace. Then you need to search for the Salesforce connector here in Mule Palette. Okay. Salesforce has different multiple bulk of operations. If you have seen, we have lot of operations in Salesforce connector. All these operations are supported by MuleSoft, and in Mule 4, as we have already know, every connector is now operation-based connector. So for each and every operation, one connector is there. So it is very easy to pick up any particular connector, and you can utilize it. So as in our next video, we are going to see the query connector, like how you can query the data from the Salesforce account and contact objects. So I'm going to drag and drop this query here in this video itself. Let's connect this global connector, and you can pull up the latest version 10.7.2. You can click on add. That particular dependency will be added to your pom.xml file, and your connector looks like this. Okay, so once that adding the Salesforce workspace class path here, it is running in green, right, at the bottom of your screen. So once this is completed, it will open up, the properties window will be open up for you. You need to click on this connector configuration to configure this global connector. Okay, and the connection types, it has different types: basic authentication, OAuth, and JWT connection. As we are using our trial account and we are using basic authentication, in your real-time projects you might expect OAuth, JWT, or OAuth 2.2, OAuth username password connections also. So as per their security measures and their security patterns, they will provide the connection method for you. to integrate. So once you have any requirement like Salesforce integration in your project, you need to first make sure what type of connection it is. It's OAuth, JWT, or we version 2.0 username and password. So because each and every connection will require a couple of attributes here. See, if I change the connection type, it will expect different attributes from one type to another type. So if you need to first confirm which type of connection it is. So once you confirm that which type of connection, then you need to get these details from your Salesforce team while in your real-time project. Okay. So in our example, we are going to use basic authentication only, as we are using trial account of the Salesforce. So once you select the basic authentication, it will ask for username, password, and security token. The username, it will email for you. You will get it from in your email whenever you receive the first email. Okay, so you need to just take that from your email, and you need to fill that password here, and you need to paste your security token here which you have received in another email, right? So this is the first email. I'll copy this username, and I need to copy this username here, and this security token you will get it in your second email with the second step which we have done. Okay, you need to copy paste this security token, and you need to give authorization URL also. Now the connector type is 50.0, it will hover for you. You can type the same URL here. The same URL you can give, the version should be matching. So here 50.0. So once you have provided all the required details, you can make sure the connection is successful or not by clicking on this test connection. Once this makes you successful, then you are good to use all the Salesforce operations. If any errors are there, it will show it up for you at this stage itself. So let's wait for this connection to be tested out. So it will take some time to provide this screen for you. So don't worry, just to keep wait for this message. So now in my case, the test connection is successful. So in this, my Salesforce connection is established successfully. So you need to click OK. And now your connector configuration is done. Now you are good to use any Salesforce query to get some details and fetch the details from any Salesforce object. We will see how we can fetch the account details from the Salesforce object in our next video. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel, Clarity Technologies, and press the bell icon so that you will get notified whenever we uploaded a new video on any of the series and any of the courses, SAP, MuleSoft, and Maastrix. Thank you. Thanks for watching.